My name is Kristie Stefanoska. I'm a science year Professor Henry Brodaty Fellow from Dementia Australia. My interest for dementia research really started very early on. I always had a fascination with the brain, and we had a family member diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. And I saw firsthand that the impact this had on not only them, but us as a family. And I realized very early on that, you know, I wanted to be a part of trying to figure out what's causing it and can we stop it or slow it down. Alzheimer's disease, which is the most common form of dementia, is linked to the accumulation of a brain protein called tau. And as it accumulates, it undergoes changes or modifications, and this makes it toxic and causes brain degeneration and eventually memory loss. And although scientists have known for years that this protein changes, we haven't been able to work out, well, what's causing these changes. And this is really what I investigated during my PhD and found that there are specific spots on this protein that they change very early on. This sets a chain reaction of further changes, and that's what makes it toxic. We have Alzheimer's disease mice. These mice have been engineered to have Alzheimer's disease, so memory loss. And the idea is by reintroducing a tau that doesn't contain these specific spots, we can see whether they have a neuroprotective function in terms of slowing down changes in the brain and improving memory or slowing memory loss. One way that we assess memory is we use a water maze experiment. This is a tank filled with water. There are four visual cues around the perimeter, and the idea is that there's a hidden platform in the tank and the mice have to learn to navigate to escape the platform. We found that by blocking these disease-promoting sites, we could improve memory function in our Alzheimer's disease mice. And this is a very big finding because it shows us that there is that this particular region in this tau protein is causing those changes that we see in dementia. And by blocking these sites on tau, we can basically put a brake on tau toxicity and dementia. This could help to improve quality of life and hopefully slow progression, and most importantly, preserve what memories remain. It may also provide a novel biomarker, so a way to detect the disease onset early, allowing for earlier and better diagnosis, and potentially provide a new therapeutic avenue. Through the support of Dementia Australia Research Foundation, I was able to continue my research, which I'm so passionate about. And none of this would have been possible without their support and funding. I've always been really proud of the work that Dementia Australia does, and I've actually raised funds for them as well in the past.